so excited to create something that's visual, lyrical, and, you know, simple. It's actually, it's not some crazy new adaptation set in a crazy new time. It's not Peter Pan in space. In fact, what it is the story itself stripped down to its barest elements. I don't know how I first became familiar with the story of Peter Pan, but I knew that it was always there, and I grew up watching the Mary Martin old movie, I grew up watching the cartoon, and I always knew that the story existed, and I kind of was obsessed with it, but I also didn't really pay it much attention until in college I read the novel for the first time, Peter and Wendy, and I was blown away by how dark and beautiful and psychological and expansive the writing of J.M. Barrie was. The idea that a happy thought, just by thinking of something that's so happy, it can make you fly. I wish there was a non-cheesy way of saying that. Something positive, it can lift you up into the air. It's a really exciting exercise to try to gather the thoughts of strangers and collect them all within this room, and that's gonna be the backdrop of our play. Funny, but it's also about looking back at your past, and it's about sort of like taking a beat, the feeling of time moving on. So I'm super excited about Custom Made Theater because of the space. It's such a solid company with really good people, and it's amazing how they sort of have this family of support. I'm gonna be using the entire space in an unconventional way. It's pajamas, it's warmly lit, it's lamps, it's candles, innovative, physical, stylized, sensitive movement. It's a story that I love, and it's something that I'm so passionate about. All children except one grow up. They soon know that they will grow up, and the way Wendy knew was this. First you need the fairy dust.